أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وكيف يحكمونك وعندهم التوراة فيها حكم الله ثم يتولون من بعد ذلك وما أولئك بالمؤمنين. إنا أنزلنا التوراة فيها هدى ونور يحكم بها النبيون الذين أسلموا للذين هادوا والربانيون والأحبار بما استحفظوا من كتاب الله وكانوا عليه شهداء فلا تخشوا الناس واخشوني ولا تشتروا بآياتي ثمنا قليلا ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الكافرون. وكتبنا عليهم فيها أن النفس بالنفس والعين بالعين والأنف بالأنف والأذن بالأذن والسن بالسن والجروح قصاص فمن تصدق به فهو كفارة له ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الظالمون. وقفينا على آثارهم بعيسى ابن مريم مصدقا لما بين يديه من التوراة وآتيناه الإنجيل فيه هدى ونور ومصدقا لما بين يديه فيه هدى ونور ومصدقا لما بين يديه من التوراة وهدى وموعظة للمتقين. وليحكم أهل الإنجيل بما أنزل الله فيه ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الفاسقون. وأنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه من الكتاب ومهيمنا عليه فاحكم بينهم بما أنزل الله ولا تتبع أهواءهم عما جاءك من الحق. لكل جعلنا منكم شرعة ومنهاجا ولو شاء الله لجعلكم أمة واحدة ولكن ليبلوكم فيما آتاكم فاستبقوا الخيرات إلى الله مرجعكم جميعا فينبئكم بما كنتم فيه تختلفون. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، نصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Last class was we were talking about Ayah 44. إنا أنزلنا التوراة فيها هدى ونور. Indeed we revealed the Torah containing guidance and light. And we mentioned Torah is the book of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام. And also the prophets and messengers after Musa from Bani Israel, they were using the book of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام, the Torah. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فِيهَا هُدًى وَنُورٍ, containing guidance and light. And we mentioned, no doubt this is a virtue for Torah, but the description of the Quran is higher than the Torah because the Quran itself is a guidance and light. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Torah, فِيهَا, which means containing. But about the Quran is Huda. Quran is light. So this is a stronger description for the Quran. يحكم بها النبيون الذين أسلموا للذين هادوا والربانيون والأحبار بما استحفظوا من كتاب الله. Containing guidance and light by which the prophets who submitted themselves to Allah made and here للذين أسلموا. And this is proof that all the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام are Muslims. All the prophets are Muslims. يعني when we mention there is Islam, معنى العام, the general meaning, and there is Islam, specific meaning. In Islam, the general meaning, all the prophets are Muslims. Adam is Muslim, Nuh is Muslim, Ibrahim is Muslim, Musa, Isa, they are Muslims. عليهم الصلاة والسلام. سليمان وأسلمت مع سليمان. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said about the lady. وأسلمت مع سليمان. It is not mentioned in the Quran that her name is Bilqis. It is common. The scholars mention her name is Bilqis. So all the prophets are Muslims. طيب. But right now when we say Muslim, the other side, Yahudi, Nasrani, okay, we mean the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. Who submitted themselves to Allah. He submitted, this is the linguistic meaning of Islam. Istislam means submission. They made judgments for Jews. So did the did the rabbis and scholars judge according to Allah's book? And we mentioned the meaning of Rabbaniyin, صح? Spoke about this point. Rabbaniyin. And Hadu means Yahud. And why they are called Yahud? Some scholars say because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned another ayah about them during the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Inna hudna ilayk. Hudna means raja'na ilayk. يعني raja'a wa tawba, repentance. So that's why they are called Yahud. And some of them said because they are from the children of Yehuda, one of the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. You know the children of Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, the 12 sons. One of them is called Yehuda. So they are related to him. So that's why they called Yehud. يعني الله علم exactly, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala no doubt called them Yehud, and also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called them Yehud. And the followers of Isa are called Nasara, because nowadays you'll find the word Masihiyin. It is not an Islamic term. It is Nasara. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith Nasara. Allah mentioned Nasara. قالت يهود عزير بن الله وقالت النصارى مسيح ابن الله. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them Nasara, not Masihiyin. So no doubt to be safe, and of course this, the right thing to stick to the words mentioned the Quran and Sunnah. You stick to the word mentioned the Quran and Sunnah. Why? To be safe. To be safe and to follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do I mean to be safe? Because you know sometimes it gives you wrong meaning. Sometimes it gives you wrong meaning. Maybe sometimes it is okay. طيب. What do you mean? Describing them. But like the Yahud, to describe them, Yahud. Okay, people of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, people of Isa alayhi salam, Nasara. Okay, why they are called Nasara? Some scholars say because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the Quran when Allah Isa alayhi salatu wasalam said, من أنصار إلى الله قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله. Okay, Nasara as a meaning, it is like Al Ansar as a meaning, help, to help, Yansur, to help. طيب من أنصاري, who's helping me, okay, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الحواريون, again also الحواري means الناصر, the supporter, like Zubair Awam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said لكل نبي حواري, وحواري الزبير. So, if there is an Islamic term, stick to that term to be safe. Like, you know, like the term al-mu'jiza. This is common in the books. Mu'jizat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, miracles. But the Islamic term, I mean, by the word Islamic, what is mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah is ayah. Ayah. Ayah means a sign. وقد آتينا موسى تسع آيات nine آيات signs طيب in nowadays book you can find you find the word معجزة معجزة طيب so no doubt to stick to the Islamic term it is safe but you will find the scholars using the word معجزة it's not haram but no doubt to use the word in the Quran أحسن no doubt so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned هادو والربانيون we mention what is meaning for الربانيون والأحبار بما استحفظوا من كتاب الله وكانوا عليه شهداء with which they were entrusted and of which they were made keepers because Allah سبحانه وتعالى protected and preserved the Quran by saying إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وَإِنَّ لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ الحفظ protection and preserving by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but here الحفظ where بِمَا اسْتُحْفِظُوا who should do this? People the rabbis and the scholars but they did not subhanallah they did not fulfill that mission they made the replacement, they concede and they ignore because of the dunya, because of the money. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect, that's why the Quran until the day of judgment will not be changed. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects the Quran. وَكَانُوا عَلَيْهِ فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسِ وَخْشَوْنِ فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسِ وَخْشَوْنِ so don't fear the people, fear me. And here the word khashya, the translation is khawf. Yes, but khawf, the fear is the general word. But if the fear because of knowledge, this is called khashya. If you fear someone, because you know he is strong, he can do this. This is khashya. Khashya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say the believers, the Muslims. He said الْعُلَمَاء. What does it mean الْعُلَمَاء? Scholars, those who have knowledge. So because the scholars have knowledge, so they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which kind of fear? Khashya. The level of khashya. So if there is knowledge with fear, this is called khashya. And if there is if there is taken an action with fear, this is called rahba. It's called rahba. So both of them, I mean the term of khashya and rahba, from the khawf. But if it is connected with knowledge, this is called khashya. If it is with taking an action, it is called rahba, rahba. طيب, فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسِ وَخْشَوُونَ Then he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا Nor trade my revelations for a fleeting gain. This is the problem. When you prefer the dunya, you are ready to sell your religion. This is one of the biggest problems. Fatwa. Halal, haram, as we mentioned about the ruling of zina, adultery. Okay, because of the people, the high class people, Allah changed the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for sure they are, Allah, as Allah subhanahu described, kaluna al-suht. Many scholars mention al-suht, he means the bribe. You give them something under the table and they change the rule for you. No problem for them. They don't care. They don't care. About the book of Allah. Book of Allah changed, no problem. The problem, there is no money. This is the biggest problem for them. Dunya, not the akhira. طيب. ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الكافرون. And yes. And those who don't judge by what Allah has revealed are truly the disbelievers. Are truly the disbelievers. And as we mentioned last week, I think that this is one of the biggest issue of يعني the Khawarij. The Khawarij made a big problem because of this ayah, misunderstanding this ayah, and misunderstanding Islam. Khawarij, young people. يعني if you notice, now those who are ISIS and Qaeda, Jabhat al-Nusra, whatever, different names, you will not find scholars among them. Not find scholars like Sheikh Mbaz, Sheikh Ma'tameen, someone who is 60, 70, who spent his life in teaching people. You will not find the scholars among the Khawarij. Who are among the Khawarij? You'll find unknown people, someone who maybe he was active in da'wah, but after some time he left the jama'ah and he created his own group and he started to making takfir of the Muslims. This country is kafir, this ruler is kafir, this scholar is kafir. Young people, scholars, you will not find scholars. And as Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala, when he discussed them, he said, none of the companions there with you. None of the companions. Which is a proof that you are wrong. The other side, you will find Muawiyah, wa Ali, wa Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, Amr the companions radiallahu ta'ala. But he went there 4,000 or 7,000, you cannot find one single Sahabi among them. What is the meaning of that? So this is important. This is important. When you attend the class, you can feel that it is strange. None of them is known. They are not using the books of the scholars. They have their own books and the names. They will not, sometimes they will not put the name of the author. The author chooses another name. He wants to hide himself. So all these are signs that they are deviant people. For Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah, alhamdulillah, this is clear. This book is written by Al-Albani. Al-Albani, you write Al-Albani. By Sheikh Mbaz, Sheikh Mbaz, yani. Why should I fear? No problem. طيب. So, الطبري رحمه الله, we mentioned some statements about this ayah, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ وأولئك هم الكافرون. They are كافرون. الطبري mentioned that Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى said من جحد who denies ما أنزل الله what Allah reveals what Allah revealed فقد كفر. He is كافر. طيب. So here mentioned the word من جحد. The one who denies. No, this is not the ruling of Allah. Or this is wrong. Okay, this is unfair. So this person is kafir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran to cut the hand of the thief, as we mentioned. He said, no, I don't accept this. This is wrong. This is unfair. So this person is kafir. خلاص. Then he said, طبعاً رحمه الله. ومن أقر به ولم يحكم فهو ظالم فاسق. And the one who accepts this ruling but doesn't apply that, then he is ظالم, oppressor, فاسق, disobedient. Why he is using كافر, ظالم, فاسق? Because one ayah, فأولئك هم الكافرون. Then the next ayah, Allah mentioned ظالمون. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned فاسقون. So الطبري mentioned رحمه الله, if you deny, then this person is kafir. If you accept this ruling as aqidah, you believe, but you are not acting upon this, then this person is ظالم فاسق. So what do you notice? He is differentiating between the اعتقاد. Yes, he believes this is right, but he's not doing that. This is ظالم فاسق. But the one who denies, no, this is not right. This is not fair, the rules of inheritance, not fair. So this person is kafir, not Muslim. طيب ابن القيم رحمه الله or before ابن القيم ابن الجوزي رحمه الله he said من لم يحكم بما أنزل الله جاحدا له the one who doesn't do the rules of Allah سبحانه وتعالى why denying that and he knows this is from Allah سبحانه وتعالى as the Yahud did then this person is كافر and the one who doesn't do that ميلا إلى الهوى because of what the desire maybe money maybe the chair the position the وظيفة the job without denying then he's ظالم فاسق طيب طبري he's from the scholars of the third century Ibn al-Jawzi from the 6th century. So they said the same. Also Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim of the 8th century. Rahimullah. He said, والصحيح and the authentic opinion that الحكم بغير ما أنزل الله يعني this ayah فأولئك هم الكافرون طيب judging by what Allah has not judging by what Allah has revealed يتناول الكفرين includes both types of كفر both types of كفر what does he mean by both types of كفر الأصغر والأكبر minor major and this is very common when you read the books of Islam you'll find for example the chapter of طهارة طيب What you will find? الطهارة الكبرى والطهارة الصغرى. The major purity, the minor purity. Major purity means غسل, taking shower. Minor purity means وضوء. And the same thing here. There is major kufr and there is minor kufr. When you come to the hereafter, the major signs of the hereafter, the minor signs. So this is very common. Major, minor. طيب. So he said, الأصغر والأكبر, the minor and the major. Major كفر, minor كفر. Okay, what does he mean by major كفر, minor كفر? Major كفر, he's kafir. He is kafir. This person is kafir, not in the fold in Islam. Minor, he is in the fold of Islam, but no doubt this is a big problem, a major problem. So, yes, major sin, like kaba'ir. طيب, يعني when we say major kufr, minor kufr, this doesn't mean minor kufr. It's okay to do it. No, it is dangerous. But this person within the fold of Islam. تمام? He said بحسب حال الحاكم. Yes. Now you mention one example regarding this point. He said, بحسب حال حاكم, according to the situation of this ruler. If he believes, here he is talking about the ruler. And of course, it's not only the ruler, or any one of us. You follow the same statement. If the ruler believes that I have to judge people according to what Allah revealed, which means Quran and Sunnah, in this incident, then I left that. The ruler is there, and there is a case, and he knows this is the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They came to him, an inheritance issue. Then he said, okay, the Quran says, the son takes double. The daughter. This is the ruling of Allah. And he knows this. And he believes this is the ruling of Allah. And he believes this is correct. But they gave him a bribe. Or because there is يعني, family relations. There is something of dunya. Something of dunya. Not as a religious issue. Dunya. He believes this is correct. He said, no. The ruling is, you're ruling here. The son takes same as the girl. Okay? He did not judge by the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He judged by his desire. Okay? Or if he knows the boy, say, the boy should take triple of the girl. So, okay? So if he believes this is correct, this is the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he did another ruling, and he knows this is wrong, and he knows he deserved to be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he said, Muqayyim, this is a minor kufr. This is a minor kufr. But in i'taqad annahu ghayr wajib, but if he believes this is not a compulsory ruling. And I have the option to choose this ruling or the other ruling. And he knows this is the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this person is doing the major kufr. He's doing the major kufr. Okay? I know this is the ruling of Allah. But I said, it's okay. If this person believes, if this ruler or this person, any person, he believes it's okay to take the ruling of Allah, and it's okay to take the ruling of the law of the country. It's okay. Both of them are okay. This person is kafir. This person is kafir, not Muslim. طيب. فهذا كفر أكبر. This is a major disbelief. طيب. Then he said, وَإِن جَهِلَهُ وَأَخْطَأَهُ. But if he doesn't know the ruling of Allah, سبحانه وتعالى. جَهِلَهُ. Ignorance, from the word ignorance. He doesn't know that. وَأَخْطَأَهُ. And he did a mistake in giving the ruling. فَلَهُ حُكْمُ الْمُخْطِئِينَ. So, he will take the ruling of those who are doing mistakes. يعني, if the حاكم, if the judge of the ruler gave his judgment according to his اجتهاد, he doesn't know the ruling of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, he doesn't know that an inheritance, the son should take double the girl. He doesn't know that. So he said, Wallahi, because this boy has a good salary and this daughter doesn't have a job, so the inheritance will be 70% for the girl and 30% for the boy. Why he gave this judgment? He did his ijtihad. He studied the case and he doesn't know the ruling. And for example, he doesn't know. طيب, he will take the ruling of مخطئ. مخطئ, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إذا اجتهد الحاكم, if the ruler, or of course the judge, he did his ijtihad, then he gave the correct ruling, Allah will give him two reward. If he did the wrong ruling, he will take one reward. طيب. So this is saying by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. So what is the point? What is the point here? The author and the scholars of Ahl-Sunnah al-Jama'ah emphasizing that not anyone judging by other than the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kafir. طيب. If the situation like the Yahud, they know the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know that the ruling of adultery is stoning. But they covered that and they concealed that to get the dunya. And they denied that. They don't want that. They are kafir. So if the Muslims are doing that, he will take the same ruling. Because the ayat about the Yahud, you'll find maybe some scholars saying this is related to the Yahud. But also the same thing. If Muslims are doing that, they will take the same ruling. If the Muslims hiding, if there is a Muslim scholar hiding the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for example, if there is a country, they don't know Arabic. Only the sheikh there. There is one sheikh and he knows Arabic. And the sheikh, the sheikh is changing the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believe this is halal. Then no doubt this is kafir. No doubt this is kafir. This scholar. طيب. Then the next ayah. Then the next ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وكتبنا عليهم. Of course, يعني when we say the person is kafir, if he believes this is right, if he believes this is wrong, the book of Allah, that he's kafir, or if he is denying, يعني it should, the issue of takfir, now we study this, the issue of takfir, but to appoint someone as kafir, you should be very careful about that. You should make sure that the person knows what is there and knows this is wajib. This course says انتفاء الموانع وانطباق الشروط عليه. يعني the conditions are there and انتفاء الموانع. يعني the things which prevent them from knowing that. Okay, because you know sometimes the person doesn't know. يعني for example, as I said, this is not only for the ruler or the judge, for any Muslim. So if there is someone who is a new Muslim and he came from a community and a society and a country, they don't know anything about Islam. يعني maybe the non-Muslims who live in Kuwait, they know. Of course, not all of them, but they know about the rules of inheritance. Some rules or few rules of inheritance that the boy takes double the girl. He knows. But imagine if there is a person who lives in a country, nothing about Islam, non-Muslim country. Then he came to Islam. You explain him the Tawheed, the pillars of faith. تؤمن بالله ملائكته كتب you told him about the five pillars of Islam, six pillars of faith. He accepted that. Then he denied one ruling of the inheritance, or he denied one ruling about to cut the hand of the thief. Immediately you say you are kafir. No, I cannot say you are kafir because you denied something in the Quran. Until now he doesn't. He did not read the Quran. Until now, he doesn't know anything about the Quran. He knows, of course, the Quran is the book of Allah because we explain him. But he did not read the 600 pages of the Quran. Or even if he read the 600 pages, but he did not understand. He did not understand. So we cannot say he is kafir until we make sure he understands what is there in the Islam. If the person knows this is the ruling by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he denied that, he's kafir. But someone doesn't know. No, he cannot say kafir. Or you know, sometimes people are confused. يعني imagine, يعني the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the authentic hadith in Bukhari, من بدل دينه فاقتلوه. The one who changes his religion, kill him. أحكام الردة. The opposite, who leaves his religion. So this ruler is kafir because he's not following this ruling in Islam. يعني you should be careful. Why? Because the problem, the misguiding scholars or da'i, يعني you know, for us, alhamdulillah, we attend lectures, we listen. So we know this person is da'i. He's not a scholar and he's a deviant da'i. But for the Amir, do you think that he knows these things? خلاص, he's doing lectures, graduate from Sharia, خلاص. I trust him. I mean, the ruler is trusting this. So this sheikh said, no, we don't kill him. And there is one da'i said that. We don't follow this hadith. So imagine if the ruler took it from this sheikh. Can we say the ruler is kafir because he is denying the hadith? يعني sometimes there is a confusion. There is a confusion. The sheikh of the scholar is misguiding Sheikh, like the time of Imam Ahmed, Rahimahullah, Bishr al-Mirisi, Ahmed ibn Abi Duad. They were the scholars of al-Ma'mun, and who came after al-Ma'mun, Muhtasim. So they were misguiding the ruler, and the ruler killed some scholars because of the misguiding opinion. So the issue to appoint this person is kafir, you should be very careful, because the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, من قال يا أخي يا كافر لحارت على أحدهم. The person, if the person says to his brother, you are kafir, this word kafir for sure will go to one of them. If this person deserves the word kafir, khalas, this is kafir. But if he doesn't deserve the word kafir, the word will come back to you. So this is very serious. To specify a person, no problem. To mention, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكُمْ كَافِرُونَ. Are you wrong to say that? No, you should say that. It is mentioned in the Quran. It is mentioned in the Quran. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكُمْ كَافِرُونَ. But yes, sometimes people are using the correct statement, but they mean a wrong meaning. Like what they mentioned during the time of Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Khawarij, they said, لَا حُكْمَ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. There is no judgment except the judgment of Allah. So what the scholars say, كلمة حق أريد بها باطل. A correct statement, but with wrong intention. يعني wrong, it's correct statement, no doubt. But they put it in the misguiding place. What do you mean that you are saying لا حكم لله, لا حكم لله? You mean Ali is wrong, رضي الله تعالى. He was not wrong. So you know, sometimes, subhanAllah, you find people taking ayat from Quran, had authentic hadith, but they put it in a place to misguide people. That's why we need the scholars to understand the Quran properly. Then the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ وَالْأَنْفَ بِالْآيَةِ. We ordained for them in the Torah. وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا. فِيهَا means Torah. Because here we are talking about the Torah. The previous ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Torah. Because then Allah will mention Injil and Allah will mention Quran. So here, وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا. فِيهَا refers to Torah. So what is written in the Torah? النفس بالنفس, a life for a life, an eye for an eye, a nose for a nose, an ear for an ear, a tooth for a tooth, and for wounds equal retaliation. طيب, or I think some translation, retribution, huh? Muhsin Khan. He wrote, anyone has Muhsin Khan? Muhsin Khan? Wound? Equal wound? Wound, huh? Muhsin Khan, equal to equal, huh? Okay, equal to equal. أحد يهاب صحيح انترناشونال ريتريبيوشن ها طيب قصاص والجروح قصاص wounds equal to equal والجروح قصاص so this is mentioned where توراة الله سبحانه وتعالى told us in the Quran that this is written where in the Torah and this is also a ruling for us. Also, this is ruling for us. How it is ruling for us and it is mentioned in the Torah? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this and also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used that ruling. You know, the story of Anas ibn al-Nadr. Anas ibn al-Nadr. His sister, al-Rubayya' radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah. She broke a tooth of a woman. So that family, the family of the other girl or woman, they ask for al-qisas. They want the punishment. Yeah. Because al-Rubayya, she broke the tooth of our daughter. We want to break the tooth of al-Rubayya. So Anas ibn al-Nadr came to know that they are asking to break they ask for al-qisas. So Anas ibn al-Nadr said, Wallahi la tuksar taniyat al-Rubayya. Taniyat, one of, you know, the names of the teeth. One of them is called Athaniya. So he said, by Allah, it will not be broken. Yani they cannot do that. So here's the statement. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا أنس كتاب الله القصاص. Oh, Anas, what you are saying? This is mentioned the book of Allah, القصاص. Okay, in the book of Allah mentioned that this is in the Torah, which means Islam agrees with what is mentioned in the Torah. تمام؟ So this is for the Torah. يعني rules and اليهودية and also those who came after Musa because they follow the book of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام and also in Islam كتاب الله القصاص. طيب of course this doesn't for Anas bin Nadhr this doesn't mean Anas that Anas doesn't believe in the قصاص. He believes in قصاص for sure, no doubt. But Anas رضي الله عنه means as a fact, this will not happen. Why? Because the family of Rubay' told the family of the other women, okay, take al-arsh. Okay, yani how much for if you break one tooth? Yeah, for example, it is 10 camels. Okay, we'll give you 10 camels. So at the beginning, they say, no, we'll not accept anything. We want qisas. The same thing, we break the tooth of Rubayya. So when Anna said, by Allah, this will not happen, doesn't mean he doesn't believe the ruling. He believes that because his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this will not happen. And yes, this يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported Anas ibn Nadhr, that later they came, the family of that girl, and they said, okay, khalas, give us the arsh, give us the compensation, and will not ask for breaking the tooth. Because this is their right, no problem. For the qisas, you have the right to ask for compensation or to compromise. Tell us, I don't want anything. This is your right. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرَّهِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, إن من عباد الله, some of the slaves of Allah, من لو أقسم على الله, يعني if he requests something from Allah, Allah will give him. So he said, by Allah, this will not happen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him by that. And there is a difference between this hadith and يعني this situation and the other hadith when the man said, you know, when there were two friends, but one of them good Muslim, or good, yes, good practicing Muslim, and the other one is not practicing. So the good practicing was advising him, be careful, fear Allah, always giving him nasiha, nasiha, nasiha. And he is not listening. So one day, this disobedient person told his friend, good friend, he said, إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي. Please go away. أبو عدت علي رقيبا يعني have Allah sent you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you as a رقيب يعني to check my actions. Please go away. خلاص. So this good man said by Allah والله by Allah لن يغفر الله لك. Allah will not forgive you. So this is a big difference. I mean this incident is a big difference. Or totally different than Anas ibn Nadhr. Because this person, I mean the second story, he's talking about the future in paradise or the hellfire. He's talking about the action of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will not forgive you. This is not for you. This is not for any one of us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished this person. While the situation of Anas ibn Nadhr, no, Anas ibn Nadhr, yeah, this is like a strong trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will not happen because of his position in Islam. So they are two different cases. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَنْ تَصَدَّقَ بِهِ فَهُوَ كَفَّارٌ. Of course, there are details about al-qisas. Okay, and you'll find a separate chapter in the books of fiqh about al-qisas. And you'll find the scholars, يعني talk about the the قصاص. Should we do it immediately? يعني القصاص النفس بالنفس. Okay, the first thing, النفس بالنفس يعني. Okay, a life for a life. What does it mean with that? It means that if someone killed the other one, طيب, is it the same if one person is a free person and the other is a slave? One person is a man and the other one is woman? I mean, there are details about that. There are details about that. You can find that in the books of fiqh, separate chapter, Kitab al-Qisas. There is Kitab al-Hudud and there is Kitab al-Qisas, different. Al-Hudud, the punishment of stealing, the punishment of adultery, Hudud, punishment of al-Qadhf, okay, accusing an innocent person with, accusing a person with zina, adultery. This is chapter of Hudud. A different chapter, Qisas. This is different. Okay, and when you come to the wounds, if someone cut a hand of a person, another person, so now we do the qisas. What the scholars mention, is it from a mifsal, is it from a joint, or it is a bone? So if it is from a joint, khalas, we do the same. But if it is from a bone, how we do it? No, we do it from the joint. Which joint? And if it is middle of the arm, here, okay. But if it is middle of the arm, we cannot do it from the same place as qisas. So we do it from a joint. Okay, which joint? The elbow or the wrist? No, we do it from which is less. Okay? But why? Because they say we cannot make sure exactly. But nowadays, it is different. Nowadays, they can do the same. Now, they can do the same. So, I mean, you'll find details. And also, should we do the qisas immediately or we should wait? And imagine if there is a wound. So, should we wait some time until we make sure what is the impact of this wound, 2 or 3 days, or we do it now? Because you know, sometimes the he will, yes, maybe he will die or he will lose more. So there are details about that. We will not discuss this. يعني, it should be inshallah in a fiqh, a book. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَن تَصَدَّقَ بِهِ فَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ. But whoever weaves it charitable, it will be atonement for them. It is not for them, it is for him. Eh? Would you have translation? You have Sahih International? It's for them? For him. This which translation? Sahih? Muhsin Khan? Him or them? Him. Here, I don't know which translation I'm using. Okay. This is not, this is the clear Quran. Mustafa Khattab? No, it is, let's change to the, okay. Yes. But whoever gives up his right as charity, it is an expiation for him. وَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ. You know, sometimes they use the, they translate according to what the scholars mention. Yes, some scholars mention it is for both. It is for both. But of course, يعني we should be careful about the translation of the meaning, that put it like this for him and you can be between brackets, which means for the one who cut and the one who is يعني the victim and the guilty person. So, طيب, what is the meaning? فمن تصدق به فهو كفارة له. فمن تصدق به فهو كفارة له. Okay. What is meaning here? تصدق. Where is the صدق? Where is the charity? Where is the charity here? Yes, the forgiveness. The forgiveness. خلاص, he broke my tooth. I will forgive you. This is charity. This is charity. طيب, فمن تصدق به فهو كفارة. Okay. So, فمن تصدق here. Okay. This is the one who forgives. فهو كفارة له. It is expiation for him. Which one? There is an opinion, the one who forgave, it is kafar for, it is expiation for him. يعني, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the day of judgment, will forgive your sins. Because you forgave him in dunya, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive this. And some scholars said, فَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ, يعني, the one who broke my tooth, then I forgave him, so it will make his sin less. And it will forgive his sin. Yes. So both sides, yeah. Both sides. So maybe this translation of Khattab, he understood this from the tafsir of the scholars. فَمَنْ تَصَدَّقَ بِهِ فَهُوَ كَفَّارَةُ لَهُ. So the one who forgave, this is charity. So this is expiation له. يعني, it can mean me. I forgave him, so Allah will forgive my sins because I forgave him. Or for وَكَفَّارَةُ الله, it will minimize his sin. The one who broke my tail. Of course, here we are talking about the one who did that intentionally. Intentionally. Okay, القصاص, not for the one who did this by mistake. يعني, if you killed someone by mistake, we do the qisas with you? No, we don't do the qisas. Okay? Because you know, there is qatl khata' and qatl amd. There is a killing by intentionally. Okay? You have a knife and you are waiting someone. Okay? And you go and you kill him with your knife. Intentionally, this is qatl amd. So we follow the rules of qisas. But if something happened by mistake, something happened by mistake. يعني, for example, you are standing in a place, maybe you are in a country, mountains, river, and waterfalls, these things. So, يعني, you stood up suddenly, then you hit someone, then he fell down and he died. You killed him. You killed him. Excellent. I did not intend it. Okay. So we do the qisas. We kill you because you killed him. No. So here we are talking, the ayah talks about what? Intentional, huh? On purpose, yes. Amd. فهو كفارة الله. Then, again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ. And whoever doesn't judge by what Allah has revealed, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. Then it is those who are the wrongdoers. ظَالِمُونَ. طيب. We stop here, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Muhammad.